So now that we have all the figurines finished, all six of them are ready to go, we just need to fondant the top and the bottom of the carousel and double, triple, quadruple check that everything will screw together and fit exactly right. So we have a lot of work to do. Let's just go. So I'm just figuring out where to start. This was a busy Saturday. We have a wedding tiered cake or a couple cakes in the background. For the carousel cake though, we needed to fondant it and decorate it as two pieces. The bottom was a separate piece, the top its own. So we decided to make sure that we kept to our correct like measurements because we have to maintain the certain amount of inches in between the two so that we have room exactly for our figurines because our figurines are pre-built. So if we have oversized them or undersized them, they're not going to fit. So for the bottom of the carousel, we have, there's a mirrored like centerpiece that probably covers up all the center support in real life. So we need to work our way in from the back to the front, from the inside out. So I can't decorate this middle iron pipe before I do, or after I do everything else. It needs to happen first. So it has mirrors and lights and painting on it. So I'm getting that done first. And then I have the wooden floor on there already. And then the animals will go on last.
So, we had to make several animals for our carousel cake. Apparently, they were animals, or are animals, that are native to New England. And we have this selection here. This is probably a harbor seal. It's not the best photo of a seal. Well, it's just, okay, Sarah, I'm sorry. It's a good seal, but it's blurry.
I did my best.
His face looks questionable, like he maybe ate some bad food. But I like seals. I kind of always wanted a pet lobster, but I don't think they would survive as pets. So we made a lobster. People like eating them. I like looking at them. I didn't know sea turtles were native to friggin' Massachusetts. Is that true? I don't think that's true. I don't think these exist around here. I'm a scientist, I know this.
Kathy's piping master, so I handed off the bottom tier to her to get sort of the simplified version of the ornate detail that's on the carousel. It has a bunch of like relief, scroll work, sculptural detailing in real life, but we kind of did a quick simplification, but still looks pretty elegant. So we had to do a couple different test screws before the final screw on, just because once we got it on there, we realized we were a quarter or an eighth of an inch not parallel. So in the front of the carousel, it was a little bit lower. In the back of the carousel, it was a little bit higher. Like I said, by a quarter or an eighth of an inch off. And we sort of built in room for error when we did the figurines on those skewers. We made them like, I can't remember. I think we made them a like quarter or half an inch longer because we knew we would probably need to trim them. And so we figured out the oarfish is the taller one, so that would go in the area where there was more height available, and some of the shorter ones would go where there was, and again, this is just a quarter and eighth of an inch off, but We figured out which ones go in the front and the side based on their height, trimmed them accordingly, and then finally we were able to screw it on, but it was definitely a two-man job for keeping things stable and straight.
What on God's green earth is this? So I never knew that this existed. It looks like a hell eel. It's the oarfish, right?
Yes.
This is not a fish. What's this whole thing? That seems like excessive. I do not want this to live here. This looks like a cod. Like Cape Cod. I thought we overfished these things to oblivion. But I guess we didn't. So they're real. They look like a pretty standard fish to me. They got some extra striping going on. I guess that's pretty fancy. Oh Lord, he coming. This is a humpback whale? No, a blue whale. Okay. So this is a baleen whale. They have baleen instead of teeth. Well, they have teeth, but they're baleen. They're like really weird. I've got to touch them. I know all this from a whale watch in Maine. They're very freaking big. They're like 100 feet long. That's excessive. And
then I had Kathy come back and do more of her, or lend more of her piping skills to the top of the carousel to mimic the bottom. And then we just have the final details with the mirrors and additional piping for lights and stuff. So overall, we really were excited to work on this carousel. We got to ride the carousel. We got to decorate the carousel. Soon, in a few minutes, we leave for delivery and we're gonna bring the carousel to the carousel, which is really exciting also. So I think next time, we're really happy with this cake. We're really proud of how it turned out. We got to use a bunch of techniques we've never done before and combine everything. It was a 3 or 4 man job to get everything decorated and sculpted. I think the next time we do a carousel, we definitely want to have it motorized. So we need the next client who wants a carousel. We want to put a motor in it so it can spin on its own. Just throwing that out there.